Hello. This is our meditation time, and it's not at dusk, and it's not in the dark. You may find that the best time for you to engage in prayer is during the day. And so I encourage you to take this time and to allow yourself to focus on Scripture and on the Lord. Now you'll see that I'm joined today by Nyx, our year-old puppy. I've done that on purpose. We're all susceptible to distractions. Some can be preventable. I could put Nyx in another room, and then I might have her whine. And you might have a pet or something that distracts you that you can't just simply turn off, like the phone, which I do encourage you to do. Turn off the ringer and turn off any notifications on your electronic devices. But there are realities of the house. You may have the washing machine going on. And as I said, you might have a pet around. There are distractions that come from within us, from our mind, that just lead us in a different way. And that's okay. Our focus will be, how do we put away those distractions in the midst of our meditation? How can we simply move on or move back into meditation after a distraction happens? The whole purpose of this time is for you simply to be with God. And you might find that going to church or watching church and listening to the sermon and listening to the readers and the music is not exactly what you're looking for. And so you may find that having intentional time with God is the best way for you. And so this is that opportunity. It's about 35 minutes. We will have a meditation time of relaxing our bodies. So it's a meditation on our bodies and being able to relax them. Then we think in our mind's eye of a place of comfort, deep comfort that we feel. And then don't look at the scripture. Don't have a Bible next to you or look up an online scripture passage and try to figure out where we are. Just allow yourself to listen and to be engaged in the reading as it would have been read to early Christians. The first time we read it, it's just to allow you to hear the story and just let it wash over you. The second time we read it, the hope is that you will find something in it that is compelling, whether it provokes thought or whether it provokes an emotion. And just focus in on what it is that draws your attention. The third reading is going to the Lord and asking God for some insight into why that particular part of the passage has meant something to you. Why has that come to the forefront? And it's a time to talk to God about it and to listen to what God is saying to you. The last reading, the fourth time we read the exact same verse, that's your time to turn to the Holy Spirit, asking the Holy Spirit for guidance in what to do with that conversation with God and those thoughts that you've had and that particular part of the verse. That's the exercise. It's as simple as listening. Contemplating. Engaging with God. Particularly with that text in mind. And then going out into the kingdom of God with that knowledge and with that call to serve. So let us relax. And I encourage you again, can't emphasize it enough, if there are distractions that you can eliminate, do so. And if we encounter distraction here, I will move us along. We will deal with it as I encourage you when you have distractions at home. So put your feet firmly on the ground and get your back as straight but comfortable as you can. And I encourage you to put your hands just on your knees or on your lap as you feel comfortable. And take a breath in and start to breathe rhythmically and deeply. It may be helpful to breathe through your nose as you breathe in, and then release out your mouth, as long as it's a rhythm that's comfortable for you, breathing ever so deeply each time you breathe in and breathe out. Breathing in ever so deeper and breathing out. And as you do so, start thinking about your hands. Maybe they're starting to feel heavy. And as you continue to breathe with intention, just allow your hands to get heavy. Don't move them. Just allow them to be. You may feel your wrists feeling ever so heavier, and your arms as well. And as you comfortably breathe more deeply and emptying out as much air as you can comfortably, you'll feel your arms and your hands relax. And you may feel your shoulders need to just have a little rotation for comfort. You may just find that that is easy for you. And that's okay. You might feel that the tension is a little less as you breathe. And feel that heaviness. And your shoulders are starting to feel it as well, and your back. core muscles on your sides. And your stomach muscles, all feeling heavier, being drawn toward the ground. I would imagine your feet are also feeling pretty heavy, as are your calves. Your legs, and even your hips, joining with the rest of your body, feeling very relaxed. And you've done this at your own pace, just by simply breathing deeply in and out, in and out. You feel that weight. It's a good feeling. It's a good feeling because you're relaxed. And you want to relax more. More deeply. You to imagine that you're at the top of a very tall circular staircase. It's not very steep. It's not dangerous. It's a simple staircase that leads down into the darkness below. I want you to think about going down those stairs, knowing that there's a wonderful place of rest once you get to the bottom. And so you begin to descend. And you go one pace down. And you feel in your mind's eye that your whole body is relaxed. Hands are heavy, your arms too. When you descend a little bit further, breathing comfortably and feeling very relaxed, you descend even further. Your shoulders are comfortable, and they're relaxed and heavy. And you feel good as you continue to descend down this staircase. Your feet and your legs, too, are feeling quite heavy. And you continue to descend down even your head and your forehead are feeling more relaxed and comfortable. And it's a good feeling. And you're taking it at your own pace as you descend down even further. Getting near your destination as you continue to breathe and feel these very comforting sensations in your body. And you can see a door. And when you arrive, you open the door and you look in, and in that space is a place that you recognize. It is a place from your past, a place that means so much to you. So many years later, maybe you haven't thought of this place in a long time, a place where you could simply be you, a place of grace. A place that was a gift. Maybe it was a refuge from turmoil, or a place of relaxation and comfort when you needed that. Whatever draws you to this special place, you're there. And as you look around, you see Jesus is there with you in this special place. And he's looking at you with deep, compassionate, loving eyes. You may feel that you need to turn away and avert his gaze. But you look again, and you see that genuine love for you within Christ as he looks at you with absolute love. And you might feel naked, or afraid, or exposed, or fearful. But Jesus' gaze is reassuring. You know he wants to be there with you, and that he cares about you. Jesus invites you in this special place to sit with him and hear a story that Mark wrote about him. And he says to you, hear what Mark wrote. This is what God's kingdom is like, said Jesus. Once upon a time, A man sowed seed on the ground. Every night he went to bed, every day he got up. And the seed sprouted and grew without him knowing how it did. The ground produces crops by itself, first the stalk, then the ear, then the complete corn in the ear. But when the crop is ready, in goes the sickle at once, because harvest has arrived. What shall we say God's kingdom is like, he said? What picture shall we give of it? It's like a grain of mustard seed. When it's sown on the ground, it's the smallest of all the seeds of the earth. But when it is sown, it springs up and becomes the biggest of all shrubs. It grows large branches, so that the birds of the air make their nest within its shade. Jesus, with great empathy, looks at you and says, listen again. What touches you? What moves you? What makes you think? And how does this make you feel? This is what God's kingdom is like, said Jesus. Once upon a time, a man sowed seed on the ground. Every night he went to bed, every day he got up, and the seed sprouted and grew without him knowing how it did it. The ground produces crops by itself. First the stalk, then the ear, then the complete corn in the ear. But when the crop is ready, in goes the sickle at once, because harvest has arrived. What shall we say God's kingdom is like? He said. What picture shall we give of it? It's like a grain of mustard seed. When it is sown on the ground, it's the smallest of all the seeds of the earth. But when it is sown, it springs up and becomes the biggest of all shrubs. It grows large branches so that the birds of the air make their nests within its shade. Jesus encourages you to ask him questions of why that particular part of this story touched you, why it moved you. And he invites you to ask him questions of it. As you continue to breathe in and breathe out, allowing yourself to feel that comfort of relaxation, you know you can ask Jesus anything. wants to listen. He loves to listen to you. And he wants to answer as well. Maybe you're still focusing on that particular part of Mark's gospel that has touched you or made you think. Maybe you simply want to talk to God at this time. Tell him things that have been spurred on by this time with him. Jesus says to you, listen once again. And think about how you can respond with the Holy Spirit's help to live this message of good news out in your life. With a loving gaze, he tells you the story one last time. This is what God's kingdom is like, said Jesus. Once upon a time, a man sowed seed on the ground. Every night he went to bed. Every day he got up and the seed sprouted and grew without him knowing how it did it. The ground produces crops by itself. First the stalk, then the ear, then the complete corn in the ear. But when the crop is ready, in goes the sickle at once, because harvest has arrived. What shall we say God's kingdom is like, he said? What picture shall we give of it? It's like a grain of mustard seed. When it's sown on the ground, it's the smallest of all the seeds of the earth. But when it's sown, it springs up and becomes the largest of all shrubs. It grows large branches so that the birds of the air make their nests within its shade. And Jesus knows it's never easy to simply hear scripture and apply it. And he encourages you to keep on thinking about what touched you, what moved you, what made you reflect on this passage. to remind yourself as you move forward on how you might be able to apply it in your life and in the lives of others, so that you may share His love. And you know that it's time to go. And Jesus looks at you with love in His eyes and gives you a hug and a holy kiss on your cheek. He tells you that He loves you, and that you are always on His mind. And you know it's time to go. You notice a door. And there's a window. That looks out into the place where you are now. And when you're able and comfortable, you can go through that door and still mindful of the comforting feelings that come with that relaxation that you started off with, that it's okay to keep on feeling relaxed today and tonight. And you know that with simple breathing, you can very simply calm all the storms around you. And so you move through the door. You might want to stretch your shoulders and your back. Comfortably and slowly. You might feel your muscles are just a little sensitive. You don't want to stretch too much. Just enough to get your body mobile and working. That it's time to go. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us go forth in the name of the Lord.